Hello. This is my first test and attempt at recording myself working through a point in real time. So here I have my writings I'm going to be doing. So on a Word document. Oops. Yep, so this is completely experimental. We'll see how this goes. Okay, but I'm gonna work on a point real time right now. One, two, three. Okay. So I was at the supermarket and I was at the supermarket and I came out of it with this experience of like irritation, of annoyance. So what happened when I was there? I was there to buy groceries and everything was pretty all right. Then I'd spoken to someone on the phone. And the response, I reacted to that. Where I was trying to do something nice and considerate for them by saying what they wanted, and they didn't really care. And that caused a reaction within me. Maybe that's because I don't really care sometimes about other people and their things. And that reminded me of that. So my body feels like a pressure cooker. Feels like irritation, annoyance, like I can get set off and explode with anger. So let's look at the point of me not caring about other people and their things. For me, it's irritating and annoying to listen to people's excuses and justifications about how hard their life is, or complaining about how hard their life is. I feel irritated, annoyed with people not doing more, not doing better. I feel irritated, annoyed with people giving up, running away, going into distraction, entertainment, being all positive and happy. Wasting their time. I feel irritated and annoyed with people who are not being serious when it's time to be serious. I'm angry and irritated at people who make justifications and excuses for them to continue to do what they do, to not really care. I don't care about these people. They're dead to me. They're dead weight. So what did I react to? So I end up using this whole design above, this irritation, annoyance, pain and pressure. It's part of the design to this whole thing here to get me to do things I need to do in life. And experience it as a positive. Like an intensity. So this has become a base habit, a base pattern of my personality where I already looked at my ego personality system, which is a very, let's say, stable point, a stable personality I've had throughout my life. And when it came to doing things like schoolwork, chores, responsibilities, I remember I would always have this intensity to do it, and that I would do it, and I would succeed. Though, you know, the question is, what is this really? And this is what it really is. And I always recognized how it wouldn't always last, and that I would have to build up for it sometimes. And there's also this element of fear as well. This explains why I look for anger for support, because I feel like I need something, and anger feels like the thing that helps me. And this includes going to people of my life, people, and this included going to individuals in my life where they would get angry at me, and then I would use that anger as support, where I would then motivate myself through their anger. You can easily imagine this maybe with a parent for yourselves. So in a way, kind of provoke an anger through talking about my problem and then have them push me to a solution. So I recognize that when I use pushing, when I push myself, it was also really part of this design. So I'm writing this here. So I see the possibility that without this, I, without letting go of the fear that I'm not good enough, that I have this ability, I have the strength within who I am. To do things to move, and I do not need this, let's say, motivation, is forcing myself, pushing myself. Okay, so thanks for watching. I have no idea how long this is. I wouldn't surprise if at least 20 minutes have passed. Hopefully, you've learned something. And this is all real time, this wasn't planned. And yeah. So thank you very much. Bye.